In this video, I am going to show you how you can use the no-code iterator action in workflows so you can loop through a list of cities selected by a user and display those cities on a map after making an API call to a geolocation API to get the latitude and longitude information for each city. So here I have a project with a multi-select where users can select a number of cities, so Paris, Mexico, Cape Town, Bangkok, Istanbul, Tokyo. These are hard-coded, but I could be binding these options to a collection of data from my backend. Here, when the user selects a city, for example, Paris, Bangkok, Tokyo, the multi-select component variable will be updated with some values. And then I have a workflow that will update the selected city markers so that my map box map can display more markers. So for now, we are only displaying New York, but as the user selects other cities, we will update this variable, make a call to OpenCage, an API call to OpenCage, which is an geocoding API, and OpenCage will return the longitude and latitude for each of the selected cities. That way we will be able to display those cities on the map. So in my workflow, I have a workflow on click where I use the iterator action, the for loop. I told the for loop, I want you to loop through the items selected by the user, so the multi-select component variable. And when you loop through each item, I want you to make an API call to OpenCage data. If I test this workflow, you see that this here, action loop item, which is the item that the loop is currently on, that the iterator is currently looping through. So here it's Tokyo. So you see that here in the query, we have Tokyo. And then we have my API key, which is just the way that OpenCage works. So if I go to quick start, this is the API endpoint that I need to call to get the latitude and longitude of a city. And here is where I would replace. I would replace this by my city name, in this case, Tokyo. And here I would have my API key. So this may change depending on the API you're using, but you get the idea. So you have a dynamic API call, and then this API will return information. And you'll need to dig a little bit to find where the information you need is. In our case, it's in the results. Here, it's buried in here in geometry. We have the latitude and the longitude of the city we're looking for. So based on this information, we can insert a new object at the end of our selected city markers. We can create an object. And the way this no-code formula works is that you enter the key and then the value and then the other key and then the other value. So here we are saying the first key is city. The city value is Tokyo, so the item we're currently looping through. And then the longitude is the result from the action. So we go and dig and bind to the longitude here. So here, like this, longitude. And our latitude will be same thing, except here, latitude. And that way, if I reset everything, so let me reset my variables. So go back to the default New York City. And here, let me remove Paris and select Istanbul instead. So I'm selecting Bangkok, Tokyo, and Istanbul. And let me trigger the workflow by clicking on the button. I see that the selected markers is being updated. The map box center is modified, and I can click here and see Istanbul. I can click here and see Bangkok. I still have New York, my starting place. And let's look for Tokyo. Tokyo is here. And if I look at my logs, let's clear this and trigger the workflow to see what's happening. So here we start the workflow on click. We start looping through three items, these three items selected by the user. There's one action, one REST API call that is made. We get the result, the first result. We update our selected city markers variable with a new object based on the result from the API. Then we loop through the second action. Something similar happens. This here is the center variable from Mapbox that is being updated with the zoom in, zoom out effect. So we don't care too much about this. Then we see we fetch the data for Tokyo and updated the selected city markers variable with the Tokyo information. Finally, we go through the loop a third time. Again, we make an API call, get the result from the API, update our variable with the Istanbul information, and that's it. The workflow is finished. The loop is finished. The workflow is done. And this again is the Mapbox center variable, which is updated, as you can see here. If you look at this, when I go to preview mode, if I refresh my page, you see this is being updated to so as to zoom in to the center of my map. That's it. That's how you can use the iterator in a no-code workflow to loop through a list of items.